One thing I want to say, which you kind of touched on it a little bit. In real estate, when you're traditionally successful, that life sucks. I'll argue that all day long. It's the premise of real estate B-School. You get to a point, AJ, you were a top agent. You're like, this sucks. Maybe Lars has the answer.
Exactly.
You were 2 years in real estate B-School. And without sugarcoating it, you're like, this sucks. You know, there's got to be a better way to do it. And you got to about $20,000 a month pretty consistently. Some months were negative 20, some months were positive 40. So it's there's no real consistency in a real estate team, even though that is the core of what Real Estate B-School teaches.
Yeah.
There was two posts in particular that really sort of put a nail in my heart around this thing was, you just hit 2,000 people in your revenue share team. There was a post on Facebook. You told your whole journey. And I was like, son of a gun, like, and I just paused. And then the other one was that my team sold 1,008 homes this month. And here I am, like, I'm the guy that has done real estate team at a very high level, maybe 60 sales in a month. And that was 3 months after we lost money, you know? So it was this overall profitable, but sort of a wild ride. And that's the kind of leverage that we're talking about, you know, and in our organization, your organization, the plan to do it is like, it is there and it's way easier than real estate. And the cool thing is not everybody will do it. Same thing. Not everybody will sell a lot of real estate.
Yeah.
So I just want to throw that out there, that those two posts that you had, and then John, you know, it's been growing in my heart. And then John called me like a week later. And he's like, are you sitting down? I went over, I'm like, no, you can't do it. And my heart palpitated. Like, I think it skipped like 9 beats. If you can, a few more minutes, can you, the second thing that got me was, I think you call her Sally in your plan. Can you tell a quick version of like what it takes to have a residual income stream of 15 grand? And what it looks like in this opportunity?
Yeah, definitely. I'm gonna see if I can even pull it up real quick.
Because I think it's a good story. So my approach to wealth building, I decided I didn't want to own a bunch of rentals. I mean, I owned 10 of them, and it was just a grind, and it wasn't mailbox money as people claim. But when I wrap my head around that example, I was like, that's like infinitely easier than any other thing I've ever learned.
Yeah.
In any aspect of business anywhere, you know? So I just think if you can kind of shed some light on that example, I think it'd be helpful.
Yep. I got it pulled up here. I want to share one thing before I forget. Like, I was just having a conversation with my friends who's not yet with EXP this week, and he's looking to, you know, expand his business, possibly open additional offices and do all these things. So the conversation naturally went towards EXP because I can't have a real business conversation with a real estate agent and not talk about it, because it would be just like lying to a person. Like, it'd be like withholding, like, if you know where the pot of gold is, like, and it doesn't, and if you have a pot of gold and by sharing with people, your pot of gold gets bigger, you share it with people. Like, that's what EXP is. And I didn't want to steal that opportunity from him. So I shared it. And one of the way the conversation went is we got to a point where I was just kind of like, before you do anything, I kind of stopped the call. I didn't even talk about EXP that much. I stopped the call. I was like, let's have a follow-up about EXP. But what I want you and your fiance, their business partners, to do is take some time over the next few days and just figure out what success really looks like for you guys in 3 to 5 years. Like, the worst and the greatest failure in life to me is if you spend the next 3 to 5, 15, 20 years climbing this mountain to get to the pinnacle of what you see as success, or what you think it might be, or maybe you haven't even thought about what it is, and you get there, and then you look across the valley that's so far away, and you realize, I just climbed this whole time, sacrificed so many things in my life to get here, and it's not even what I want. So, like, when you think about life like that, you can start to evaluate things differently. You can start to look at opportunities, look at what you're doing a little bit differently, and start to think, is this the vehicle that's going to get me to where I really want to go? So,
yeah, I want to share another story there. A guy that we both know, decided to go build his own brokerage. He has 44 agents. I had a conversation with this guy, and so successful in his market with what he did, you know, boutique, real great look, exposed brick, lots of glass in the office, all of that stuff. He is grinding 7 days a week on personal production because the thing he built is, it hasn't given him even a little bit of freedom. You know, so it's such a good point, like, you know, of all the options available, and this wasn't really available to many people until you actually see it. But anyway, I just think there's so many examples of that where you're just going up the wrong mountain, you know, and so, yeah.
It's pretty much every top producer, business owner, independent brokerage, top team that I talk to, they don't have a clear picture of what they really want out of life. But what I do know, Lars, and what I think people eventually get to is what they don't want. They don't want to not see their kids. They don't want to constantly be working nights and weekends or when they're on vacation, negotiating offers and not being present. A lot of it's not even the time aspect that you put into your business, but like when you're not working, are you truly present? They don't want the stress. Like, these are things that people don't want. So it's like, if your goal is to not have those things, like you want time with your family, you want a healthy life, you want presence with the people you love, and your goal to get there is to 10X your current business that already doesn't give you those things, you're going to have 10X the problems. You're not going to have a solution. It's like, it's going faster down the wrong highway. Like, you're going to get there and you're going to get there faster, but it's not going to be at the correct destination. All right, let me share this presentation here that I have. Really simple example. It just takes a couple minutes to watch. You can see that okay, Lars?
Yep.
Cool. So I put this together because I started to think, like, you know, my whole foundation for what I want to help people accomplish is create financial freedom. And if you study financial freedom, there's a movement out there called the FIRE movement, financial independence, retire early. I like the FI part, financial independence, because I love business and I'll always have my hands in it at some capacity, but doing the things I love. And so financial independence. Well, the best study that we have to look at is called the Trinity Study. It was done in the late 90s, I believe. And what they were able to see is that if you're going to retire, your nest egg, whatever the nest egg you have, you can safely spend 4% of it per year and not run out of money. Like, there's like a 97% chance you won't run out of money over a 30-year period. So like 4% is the number that most financial planners will use. So this example is going to show you, if you wanted to retire, or if you just wanted a residual income while you're working, of $15,000 per month, $18,000 per year, you would need $4.5 million saved and invested to do that traditionally through traditional investing, you know, and this would be like a low cost index fund. $4.5 million is a lot of money. Lars, you and I have had a lot of conversations about this. We've both been high income earners for you much longer than me, but I've been making pretty good money for a while. And a net worth of $4.5 million as an agent, close to impossible to achieve. Like, maybe when you're like 60, 70, and you've been selling for like 20, 30 years, and you're one of the biggest producers in your market, the average agent only makes $40,000 per year. That, and you got to live on that.
That's, and you'd like, have to, and you'd have to save. So I was at a $20,000 a month savings schedule before I entered EXP. I had liquid 2.4 and I was still $4.8 million off. I was still 20 years off on $20,000 a month going right into savings.
Yeah.
And that's when, like, when I saw this, I was like, oh my gosh, how did I miss this?
Like, yeah. Well, I just got to say, I love both you and John for, you know, coming over and eventually being open-minded. So I don't hold that against you guys, because it's actually the best story. Like, I love stories, you know, like that. Like, it's like, I didn't want to see it, but then when I saw it, I put my pride aside and took action on it, because stories like that is what's going to get the next wave of people over. The people who have taken a little look, then we need them to take the whole look, and then they'll come. So I think, I forget what you called her, but I call her Donna.
Oh, so, Sally.
So this is Donna, and Donna's an agent with eXp. She just joined, and she's like, you know, I'm going to keep selling houses like I always did at my previous brokerage, but I'm going to build revenue share part-time. This is the story of the majority of our agents. Very few people ever, you know, start selling houses and then retire from selling houses like I did. I don't really know many at all, like maybe a couple. But it's possible. And most people just like selling houses. Like if you like selling houses, great. Just don't make it to where you have to sell houses. So Donna's part-time, full-time selling houses, part-time building rev share. Part-time building rev share, the way I look at it, is like 3 hours a week initially as you're getting started. So Donna has a 3-year plan. I told you my 5-year plan was to get 25 agents personally. Her 3-year plan is to get 10 over 3 years. So she would have 10 agents on her first tier. If they're a capping agent, now a capping agent at eXp pays $16,000 into the company, then they cap, they keep 100% of their commission. And in most parts of the country, it's going to be about 8 to 12 sales a year. So nothing crazy. So if they're a capping agent and you personally sponsored them, you can earn up to $2,800 per year from that capped agent. So that'd be about $28,000 on your first tier there. So Donna likes what she sees. She's getting about 28 grand a year now residual. She's like, well, what if I help them also grow residual income, grow this additional stream of income for their businesses? So she's going to not only attract her 10, but also teach them how to go out and get their 10. I just say 10 by 10. It's simple math. It keeps it easy. So it's the 10 by 10 strategy. So 10 by 10, that's 100. So on her second tier, she has 100 people. Now 100 people on her second tier is worth up to $320,000 per year in income, because you can actually earn a little more on your second tier agents. So you can earn up to $3,200 per year on a capped agent on your second tier. So this is where it gets really exciting. This is where your efforts are 2.4% of the opportunity. What the effort she put in really was the 10 that she got. And now this is where it starts to get exponential. So let's add in the first and second tier. That's $348,000 per year residual income. So Donna's excited about it. She's like, I did it. I'm financially free. But then she's like, wait, what if they're not all cappers? So of course, they're not all going to be cappers. Not all of them are going to get 10. Some will get 50. Some will get 0. Some will get 5. And not everyone's going to sell 8 to 12 houses. Some might sell 20. Some might sell 50. Some might sell 2 or 0. But let's just use the NAR average. Now, the NAR average, last time I checked, the average agent sells like 6 homes a year. So in our model, 5 to 6 homes a year is like a half capper. A half capper is selling 5 to 6 homes a year. So we're going to go and use the NAR average. So let's just cut in half. Instead of a full cap, they're a half cap. That's $180,000 per year if we just cut the opportunity in half, because they're not all cappers. So from an organization of 110 agents, you have the opportunity to make $15,000 per month. So it's like you have two choices: attract agents and help them attract some agents, or save $4.5 million. I know it sounds silly and a little hard to even imagine that those are the two choices you have as an agent to create a nice residual income for yourself, but that is the reality, and that reality exists now because of eXp. And to kind of just kind of share where I'm at today, I have just shy of 3,500 agents in my group. By the end of this year, I'll have over 5,000, it looks like, which will be the end of my 5 years. I said my 5-year goal was to have 500. It should end up over 5,000, which means to me, and should mean to you, that this is actually 10x the opportunity that most people who are even excited about it even thinks it is. So it's just been a wild ride. And one of the best things, Lars, you know, it's like, on my path to becoming financially free, it was all about the money. And I always heard people say, you know, it's not about the money. You know, once you stop thinking about the money is when you'll really start to grow. And when you really add value to people's lives, that's when, you know, financial resources will come abundantly to you. And with this model, that's the truth. And once your financial needs are taken care of, the best part about this opportunity is the friends that you get to build with, and having all of the amazing people in my group that I've been able to build with over the last 4 years, and now having you and John in the last 6 months, two of my great friends come over, and the time we get to spend together as families and really do life together, because that's what's so special about the life we get to live is doing with others and having really awesome experiences like snowboarding and skiing and dinners. And next year, if you don't ski and snowboard, we'll do some snowmobiling and some curling on the ice. You know, I saw you could do that in Breckenridge too. So we just invite you to do this with us, to do life with us, to do business with us. We're partnering together. We're doing it together. And it's the most fun I've had in my life. You know, Lars, show your squirrel real quick.
Yeah.
So Lars always talks about in his coaching, don't chase squirrels. And that's why Lars actually laughed in my face when I told him I was joining EXP, because he thought I was chasing squirrels. And maybe I was, but it's worked out. But I'm the type of person that traditionally has chased squirrels. I get bored with things very easily. I was 3 years into real estate, got Lars coaching because I was already looking for a way out because I was burned out. I knew that I needed something more. And I'm almost 5 years into this now, and I'm more excited today than I was 4 years ago. This is all I do. This is what I love. This is what I'm passionate about. So it's like, it's just really, really been awesome, man.
And I'll kind of end with this.